introduce you to the 505's Big Brother. That Big Brother is the 407.
Welcome everybody to a virtual demo. Sadly we can't take you flying because we're still under restrictions, so we thought we'd do what we did with the 505 and take you on a virtual demo. So we have power on at the moment, we're on external power because it's a bit of a cold day, first start of the day, always good to use ground power. And one of the things you notice straight away is the screens light up instantly as opposed to the standard Garmin 1000 that we showed you previously in the Bell 505. These are almost instantaneous. Now these screens, as we said before, are now fitted standard to the 407 and to the 505, and you'll notice that the clarity is a lot sharper and they're just so much quicker. So first portion of the start is to hit this right key here, it says press enter. And what we're checking here is exceedances in this box, very similar to the 505, and this is a great feature. It just shows on the last flight, if you rent it out or somebody else has borrowed it, that nothing has been exceeded. You can't delete it, it's there, it's up to an engineer to interrogate it and find out what went on. The next thing we want to check is the fuel valve is on, which it is. Rotor brake is stowed, which it is. And we want to go through the warnings. So we press and hold the master caution for 5 seconds.
Engine out. Fire.
The last one's not a particularly pleasant one, is it? There'll be a link to show you what all of those tones are for. That's just checking that they are all functional. HTORS is functional and online now, which is excellent news. The next thing we'll check is the pedal stop, which is here. So the 407 has a pedal stop. It's designed to stop you putting full left pedal in at 140 knots. Quite why you'd want to, I don't know. So we put apply the left pedal, back to the center, we press pedal stop. Solenoids engage, push the left pedal again, you'll find there's less movement, back to the center, solenoid will release and we get full left pedal again. And all you're checking there at 60 knots, the solenoid will engage, restrict the pedal movement, and then when you come below 60 knots it will disengage so you get full pedal again. There is an emergency override which is on a pull down here should you need it. Okay, we're now ready to start. The area is clear. We've got 25.1 volts, which is sufficient for starting the 407. We need 24. Battery's off because we're on ground power. We have the captions that we'd expect to see. We start the 407 in idle. Now, if you go to idle and you exceed more than 60 seconds before you start, you will need to go back to off and back to idle to reset, because it just thinks you've forgotten to start it up. So just check the throttle, into idle, to fly, to maximum, back to idle, back to off. Just checking that the freedom of the throttle is good. The area is clear, we have sufficient voltage, so we go to idle. Boost pumps are on. Now that will clear the captions for the two boost pumps and the transfer pumps, four pumps in total. Now what we're going to do is hit the start, hold for 2 seconds and let go.
Start is engaged. Light off has occurred. Temperature is climbing, rotors are turning. It'll come for a second swing. You'll hear the fader catch it as she gets near the top. Beautiful start. We can see at 50% NG, start has disengaged, it's now self-sustaining. Now we're on ground power, so we now need to have that disconnected. With the help of our naval assistant. Okay, now we can put the generator on. Check that we are getting a positive flow. We've got 40 amps being pulled, and we've got 28.4, so that's perfect. T's and P's are already in the green. And we can put our position lights on. A bit of defog just to clear that. This aircraft does have air conditioning as well, but a bit of defog will clear that just as quickly. And while we're sitting here, we'll do an autopilot check. So the friction must be off for the autopilot check. Engage the autopilot, the lights will flash and it will do a self-check. You'll see the sidekick move. Go to the right, to the left. We're now just going to check the hydraulics. So it's a simple check, pull the hydraulics, make a simple X pattern with the cyclic. And you also just want to put a little bit of collective on, not too much. Yeah, everything feels normal there. Hydraulics back on, the caption will clear. Okay, we're ready to go to 100%. Now, unlike the previous 407, we can just pull the throttle straight to fly. And the dual fade deck will now make sure we don't exceed 40% torque during the run-up. We're into fly. You can see the torque's hovering around the 35% mark. We're about to get the low RPM. We're at 100%. T's and P's are in the green. Autopilot we haven't selected yet, which is why it shows it's failed. Everything else is ready to go. So, next thing we're going to do is just a spot turn to the left. This is just to get a good feel of the tail rudder authority, which on the 407 is excellent. Very little pedal required for the turn. Let's do it nice and gently, no need to rush. I found beautiful. We try one to the right, we are clear. Again, nice and slowly, no need to rush. So little pedal. Happy with that. Okay, we'll try a little bit of cross controlling, so a bit of sideways left. We are clear to the left. Very controllable, the 407, very maneuverable. And the same to the right, we are clear to the right. A little bit to the rear. I'll pick the tail up a little higher for reversing. Good idea though, look out the window, not at the video screen. Very nice. That's ground maneuvers complete. Let's go do some flying. Similar to the 505, 407 has so much power. So we can show you what the vertical climb as we did on the 505. Now we are limited to 2,000 feet a minute on the 407. Cloud base isn't great, but we'll do what we can. So we're sitting in a nice hopper, we're pretty much at sea level. We've got about half a tank of fuel. We are clear above, and we won't pull max power. Now you can see already a good positive rate of climb. Already climbing at 1,000 feet a minute. We're pulling 83% torque. You don't need to pull much power in this aircraft. Climbing beautifully. Great for confined area, tight sights. Put a bit of defog on. And there we are, top of the climb. Let's head south. So we're just coming up to 80 knots. We still want to know how the aircraft feels before we start to commit to high speed, etc. So we'll try a nice gentle turn to the left. We are clear to the left. Just put a bit of roll in. Vibration levels don't change. Absolutely smooth. Beautiful aircraft to fly. Effortless, I think would be the word. And back to the right, we are clear to the right. That's how it makes a great sound too. On the 505 video, we demonstrated hydraulic failure. We're going to do the same in the 407. Again, it's very benign with hydraulic failure. So we're just sitting around 95 knots, good speed to demonstrate. So we're straight and level, everything is clear ahead of us. Hydraulics are off. We'll get the caption come up, say hydraulic system has failed. Now, as with any hydraulic failure, don't rush to do anything. So we'll try a gentle turn to the left. We are clear to the left. Just a nice gentle turn, no need to overcook it. And back to straight and level. And we'll try and turn to the right. Now let's say we're miles from an airfield and we do need to put this aircraft down. We can see on our wind indicator here, we've got 7 knots slightly over my right shoulder, so we want to come into wind if we can. So we'll just pick a field over to our right hand side where it's clear. Start reducing power. And we're on our speed back somewhere about 70 knots would be nice. Rate of descent has started, we're just going down at 250 feet a minute. Grass area ahead of us is good. Long shallow approach. Controllable. Nice 500 foot a minute rate of descent.
Caution, terrain.
HTOLS has kicked in.
Caution, terrain.
And hydraulics coming back on.
Caution, terrain.
Okay, one of the things that 407 is known for, like the 505, is speed. So we're currently doing 100 knots. We go back to engine page, so you can see it clear at 57% torque. So we're doing 206 speed with 57% torque in hand. So let's increase power. So now we've got 87% torque in hand. Speed's already just passing 120. A little more, keep a bit in hand. We are straight and level, speed's just passing 130. And it will just keep building. And we're not pulling max power. 135. There you can see we're already heading pretty quickly for VNE, which is 140. So if we pulled a bit more power, which I'm not going to do, the aircraft will hit VNE straight level in the cruise. I mean, we're now doing 137, so it's a fast aircraft. If you want to get up the country quick, the 407 is the way to do it. So this aircraft is also equipped with an autopilot, which is an optional extra. So we'll demonstrate just a couple of features of the autopilot. So if we engage it, hit autopilot, attitude. Now the two main features you're going to use are altitude hold, heading hold. So we've now engaged the autopilot. We can see here we've got heading and altitude selected. I keep my hand near the cyclic, as you always do with any autopilot, you know, below there.
Master radio, Golf 5 Echo Uniform.
Incredibly reliable these days. You just want to keep your hand clear. So if we want to change direction, this is just purely setting heading and altitude. So if I turn the heading boat to the right, aircraft turns right until it comes onto its new heading. Now this is what you'll use 90% of the time. This is just unloads your workload on a long trip, so you're going to have more time for nav, communication. And let's assume that we now have a change of plan, and I now want to go to LID to get fuel. So autopilot is flying, we are clear ahead, so go to. Enter the code for LID, echo golf. You could just do it by map pointer as well. Shows LID here, activate, yes. Now it's drawn our magenta line to tell us which way we need to go, but I want the autopilot to take me there, so if I now hit nav, you'll see it's captured EGMD. We're 29 miles away, so bearing a 214. Our line has changed, we're now following the magenta line. Aircraft's taking us to LID. That's so simple. Now the other really good thing about NXI screens, you can sit at home. If you have Garmin Pilot loaded onto your device, you can put your flight plan in, come out to the aircraft, Bluetooth it to the screens, it will load your nav on, and the autopilot will fly your route. Now that's in a light helicopter, that's a fantastic feature. The 505 will also be able to do that as well, so the Bell product is really coming on. Now as well as the Bluetooth for your screens, your passengers, clearly not the pilot, can also Bluetooth their music device, their iPhone, etc. And you can play your music in the rear wirelessly. And the cabin, with this intercom system, we can split it so it's pilot, pilot and co-pilot, pilot isolated, crew isolated, or passengers and everybody together. Very flexible system, as this aircraft really is about the passenger experience in the back. Now, as a pilot, it's fantastic to fly. But if you're a passenger in the back, there's no other way to get around. You've got to go to a much larger aircraft to beat it.
This is the end. Hold your breath and count to ten. Feel the earth move and then hear my heart burst again. For this is the end.
The end. Clearly not the end. We're just getting started.